Good evening and welcome to our parents, grandparents, families, and friends, to our Deputy Superintendent, Dr. Sonia Stewart, and our school board member and city councilwoman, Jenny Hill, to our Chief of Opportunity and Access, Dr. Neely Parker, and our County Commissioner, Mr. David Sharp. We're so happy to have you all here. Welcome to our faculty. Will they please stand so we can recognize them and thank them? And most importantly, welcome to our seniors, the class of 2022. This amazing group of dreamers has accomplished so much as artists, writers, actors, singers, dancers, filmmakers, musicians, and theater technicians, and also scientists, historians, scouts, servants of our community, advocates, protectors of the environment, debaters, scholars, and so much more. They are talented, they are smart, they are thoughtful, they are ambitious, and they are kind. As I think about getting to this day, it is important to look back and recognize that they made it through what have been arguably the most three challenging years of education ever. Contact tracing, hybrid learning, quarantining, remote learning, more contact tracing, masks, opening schools, closing schools, changing schedules, you all get the idea. And just as a side note, we aren't shaking hands tonight on the stage because of all that. But this group of students has demonstrated an extraordinary amount of flexibility and resilience. And those traits will carry them very far in life, flexibility and resilience. And I believe we should all be very proud of them. On behalf of the faculty, I can say that we are grateful that each of you walked through our doors this year. You have inspired us and you have touched our lives. Please be sure to stay in touch with us, students, or actually almost to be graduates. Keep us updated on your lives. Come back and do a master class or a performance, just as those before you have done. And come and see the next generation of CCA students, or just stop in to say hello. And know that we, as a faculty, will always be here for you. We wish you great happiness and success in your futures. As you move through life, please remember to always be a dreamer. And now, it is my honor to introduce our salutatorian, Faith Ann Hawkins.
I'm Faith Ann Hawkins. I go by they, them pronouns. I know many of us have never talked, so I wanted to introduce myself. In all honesty, I regret never reaching out to any of you. I spent these 4 years with my head down, feeling like I didn't really deserve to be at CCA, that I needed to prove myself. And I spent those years sacrificing any social life so I could get my schoolwork done with my unhealthy learning style. And once again, I find that, in all honesty, to be such a mistake. I backed off due to the anxiety and fear of social interactions, the unknowns and variables that other people are and how they could affect me. Silence doesn't take care of that fear, I found. It just piles it up. But now we're moving on. And the thing with that is that up until now, everything we've done seems to have been planned out. There was a clear path, a next step. We had the rules and regulations of our school and the expectation that we would pass our classes and move on to the next grade. Now, that doesn't exist anymore. It's been thrown onto us to figure out our rules, ourselves, our next step. And after so many years of our worth being defined by our grades, our testing skills, our rank, our ability to find the slope of the tangent line, we get to see what really defines us. We're choosing a path. But this path is still restricted not anymore by rules or regulations, but by our societal system itself. Money stops people from achieving what would make them happy, as we still have to fight for our rights. And I know many of you don't know me, but I know me, and I know I'd be happiest far from concrete, in a little cottage with bees and native wildflowers, and a willow tree filled with fireflies and a sunflower beside me. But the bees are disappearing, and living in a cottage doesn't pay, and children will soon never have the experience of running through the grass to catch a firefly. The society treasures this paper money so much that we've forgotten or even turned against what gave us life. The planet that has enriched us and so many other things has been poisoned by its own children. And I can't say it'll be all fine if we just hope. We have people who won't live to see it, but in the next 50 years we'll run out of oil to take from the earth. And the ones who won't see this day are the ones not worrying about it, passing bills and burning resources as we sit and watch with no control. And after 17 years of sitting silent with my head down, I've gotten tired of never seeing a change. And one voice alone is too weak to change much at all, but a joint effort to shout what needs to be heard will make it through. Maybe not to those making the laws, as their ears seem to be plugged by corporations and corruption, but others will hear and learn and grow. And they'll learn that it's not our planet that needs saving. We're not in the right to hold that power. A Stuart Brand has said, "Talk of saving the Earth is overstated. Earth will be fine no matter what. So will life. It's humans who are in trouble." So we're now faced with choosing our own destruction or changing, because humans cannot survive if we continue on this way. It's up to every single person to get over that fear and break the silence. And while we cannot stop the corporations that do the most harm to our planet and our lives, we can join together in a fight to change what the future holds for us. I hope then that the fear inside of me will dwindle in the face of needing to do something, take some action, take one more step forward. Because I know if I stay silent forever, I will lose all the little things that make me smile. Because our future shouldn't be one of fear, but instead one lived for those little things. You know, the ones, those moments where you stop in your steps and feel the air moving in and out of your lungs for the first time that day, and you see clearly for a second before walking on. And these dear little things that make me smile are what I live for, and every single thing on this planet has these little things that make them smile. And I'm so entirely in love with these stupid little things that I write them little love letters. Love letters to the earth, the bees, the fireflies, the trees, and the plants that people call weeds. The oceans, the little villages in Alaska, the raspberries and rocks and the rain and the banjos and the sunflower. And so while we are constrained by so many factors, we are now seeing what we hold close and true to our hearts. And it seems it will never be a day of rest. We continuously, endlessly counted down the time until the clock would hit 3:58. Or we'd make it to those two promised days off each week. It shouldn't have to be this tireless, this endless, this overworking that we lose all passion and hope, but I'm sorry to tell you, we must keep working and pushing or else we can never live for the little things that make us smile. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Susanna Champlin. First of all, I want to say how grateful I am for the opportunity to address you all tonight. I have attended school with many of you for all of middle and high school, and it is wonderful to see all the great things we have accomplished. I feel honored to be part of such a remarkable group of talented, intelligent, and kind people. The past 7 years has been special because of each and every one of you. I'd like to thank the people who got us all here. I want to express my deepest gratitude to our parents. Thank you for your tireless support and endless amount of patience. Thank you for being the support systems that nurtured and cared for us. Thank you to all of our found family, to the people that have become our family over the years and cherished us like blood relatives. Most importantly, thank you to our teachers. To learn from all of you has been enriching and inspiring, but to get to know you has been the greatest privilege of all. I'd like to extend my gratitude to all of you for granting us your wisdom and shaping us into the people we are today. In writing this speech, I kept coming back to one central idea that sprung out of one of my childhood memories. I recall running amok with my siblings at Coolidge Park, and after our playtime ended, being reminded by my mother to leave the place better than we found it. For us, that usually meant picking up several pieces of trash or making sure all play equipment was put back correctly. Perhaps you all had similar experiences. This sentiment has been something that has stayed with me, and I've realized it meant more than simply caring for your surroundings. Each of us is linked to our communities. Through our interactions, the friendships we foster, the people we learn from, and the care we provide to others, we inherently change these places. Just this year, our class has positively transformed our school community through fundraising, mentoring the eighth grade class, and laying the foundation for a school garden. On an individual level, perhaps some of you have taken on an older sibling role for your younger classmates, like I have. In the broader community, through our accomplishments, we have spread our care for others even outside our school walls. All of us are the lifeblood of our community. We find familiarity within each other, even if that means passing the same people in the hallway or complaining about the wasps on the senior patio with the same people every day. In 10 years, if you were to visit CCA, it would feel like an entirely different place, despite a seemingly unchanged setting. We exist only in our togetherness, which is something that becomes fundamentally lost when we are interspersed into new communities. That can mean going off to college, joining the military, going to trade school, or simply moving away. But that's okay. The community we once all shared stays alive in our memories. Know your impact is long-lasting. After we are long gone, our influence remains, even if it's just in the people we've touched along the way. And talking about these new communities that we'll be entering in the coming months and years, I have a bit of advice for you all, if you'll allow me to share something that I've learned. These are places we will eventually make our own. However, I urge you to be thoughtful and careful in this endeavor. Take a step back to observe and learn first. Making the effort to learn about your new community makes a world of difference to those who already inhabit it. And I know I'm only appealing to a select few of you with this anecdote, but please stay with me. I know that many of us have, that those of us that have attended CCA since sixth grade, remember Mr. Eccles, our sixth grade English teacher? Perhaps, yes, I love him. So perhaps you recall being packed into the library with the rest of our class for a grade level meeting, I believe it was about halfway through the school year. Something that Mr. Eccles said during that meeting has stuck with me for the past 7 years. He asked all of us to look at our classmates on our left and our right and told us one of those peers would not be there when we graduated. At the time, many of us found this unfathomable, but his words rang true. There are many of our classmates that no longer attend school with us, but over the years we have embraced these changes and thrived despite many challenges, and we are the ones to make it to the end. In the same way, we are fundamentally different from our sixth grade selves. We've been shaped and cultivated by our peers, experiences, and communities, and I can't help but be in awe of our impacts on each other. So, at this time, if you'll humor me, I'm going to ask you to look to your classmate on your left and your right. That means y'all. You might not see these people again, and that's okay. Know that either directly or indirectly, you shaped these people. Our school community is forever changed because each and every one of you were in it. Thank you for the opportunity to be influenced by all of you. We are leaving behind a community that is better than we found it. Thank you.
Thank you, Faith Ann and Susanna, for a wonderful job. Let's give them one more round of applause. And will our seniors please stand? So we need just a minute to get our musicians in place. We're about to make it all official. All right, by the power invested in me by the superintendent, the Board of Education, and the state of Tennessee, I accept and affirm these students as meeting all the requirements for graduation set forth by the Hamilton County Board of Education and the state of Tennessee. Congratulations.
With the powers granted me by the state of Tennessee and the Hamilton County Board of Education, it is my privilege and honor to accept this class. I hereby certify that these members are duly authorized graduates of Chattanooga High School Center for the Creative Arts. Congratulations.
And for our very enthusiastic audience, as we do start to call the names, we will call them one at a time so students have their whole walk across the stage and their picture taken before we call the next. So there's lots of time to cheer and applaud them. But please make sure that we kind of settle that back down for the next graduate so we can hear everybody's name, so every family gets to hear their graduate's name. Thank you so much, Dean Hale.
This is such an exciting moment. Alicia Denise Armstrong. Addison Elise Arnold. Abdullahi Ba. Elliot Bradley B. Haven Isabella Blair. May Ruth Buck. Tyson Elijah Buck. Keenan Tariq Burrows. Darius LaRon Calloway. Liam Michael Carpenter. Susanna Renee Champlin. Joshua Michael Clay. Kyra L. Coleman. Abraham Odin Coons. Lana Nicole Crowley. Kinsley Grayson Crowdis. Kimberly Torres Delgadillo. Christian Thomas Duquette. Layla Riley Fincher. Emma Jane Friedel. Araya Nicole Goldston. Congratulations. Ja'Asia Lanaya Gladden. Raven Kennedy Ham. Jalen Marquis Harris. Faith Ann Kalea Hawkins. Josephina Aurora Helm. Tranquility Leandrea Hill. Lola Regina Howell. Zachary Ferdinand Huseman. Callista Bell Janakis. Jaden Simone Jester. Kendall Grace Johnston. Lucas West Johnston. Season Jalen Jamari Kelly. Olivia Norma Kelly. Melina Autumn Kennedy. Isabella Fabiola Kessler. Alexander Harrison Kurtz. Mason Connor Lewis. Lindsay Elizabeth Loden. Annika Jahan Love. Jordan Elizabeth Lavorn. Avery Rose Lloyd. Mia Kalina Mayo Gunther. Leighton Haley Marshall. Cody Campbell McCoy. Ashley Ann McDonough. Megan Grace McGarvey. Lillian Grace Michael. Isabel Marie Miller. Jabari Davion Mitchell. Emily Lynn Motley. Carolyn Annalise Mullins. Irie Ella Olson. Michaela Lake Petriccioni. Nathan Ryan Pickett. Danielle Shanice Pope. Lovely Therese Pulliam. Ellen Grace Rich. Miles Jameer Robinson. Chase Hunter Rucker. Pluto Nicole Setlich. Ryan Christopher Shirley. Jessica Katarina Jarva Smitherman. Nyla Simone Story. Ian Garrett Swafford. Mateo Quintel Tibbs. Oh. Alexa Allison Walker. Lydian Sula Warren. Madeline Jacoda Warren. Blake Allen Weber. Samantha Nicole Weber. Thaddeus James Weiss. Cameron Nehemiah Young.
Please rise for the singing of our alma mater.
Unlock the future. Here's to the dreamers. They hold the key.
Congratulations to the newest class of the newest class of CCA alumni. Here's to the dreamers. It is now time to toss your hats.